Hi, in this video I'm gonna briefly show you my DIY oscilloscope probes. These are really simple probes, just made of PNC connector, coaxial cable, a resistor inside here and a pin header connector. So why would you want to make probes like this? First of all, conventional oscilloscope probe, while it's okay for a quick probing, these clips are usually quite cumbersome. They don't want to stay in place, and this crown clip is not so great either. Furthermore, when you clip this something, you have this really long crowned loop here, which adds significant inductance and limits the bandwidth of the probe. So even if it says here 500 megahertz, which is quite a lot for this kind of passive probe, you cannot reach that by using this crowned clip. So you need to use the barrel connector here with a short crowned lid. So when you use a connector like this and just plug it on a pin header on your board, you have really short crowned loop. So effectively the bandwidth of this kind of probe is quite high, although it's really, really simple. So bandwidth, practicality, and the drawback in this one is the impedance. So I've used 1K resistors here. So basically this is the impedance of the probe is only 1K instead of the typical 10 mega ohms you have in a conventional oscilloscope probe. But that 10 mega ohm is only in low frequencies, and because of the probe capacitance, it does get a lot smaller when the frequencies increase. So with this kind of probe, the 1 kilo ohm, actually you can maintain it until quite high frequencies. So what do you need to build these probes? Just PNC connector, coaxial cable. I would recommend the RT174 because it's thin and flexible. So this is 50 ohm cable, and I've used through hole resistors in the probe. This is actually 953 ohms. So this together with the 50 ohm in your oscilloscope creates the 1 kilo ohm. I've explained this a bit in more detail in my blog post. And then I've used the pin headers here at the end, just because I use pin headers a lot on my boards. But if you have a bit more measurements to do, for example, you can solder this probe directly on your board. And that's actually where this whole idea comes from. Howard Johnson in his book described this kind of probe soldered directly on a test board. So how are we gonna use these probes? So the whole thing is designed to be terminated by 50 ohms. So your scope must have 50 ohms selectable in its input. If not, then you need to use an inline terminator here between the PNC and your scope input. So for example, my Keysight probes, they have this kind of simple contact pin here. So if I plug in the Keysight probe, the scope recognizes it. It knows that it's a 10 mega ohm probe with 10 to 1 attenuation, but obviously when you plug in a PNC like this, the scope has no idea what's plugged in. So in these scopes, then in the input you select 50 ohm, and then it gives a warning because there is no high impedance input at the moment, so you need to be sure that you're not exceeding the maximum voltage. But yes, and but now it's 50 ohms, shows here. Then you need to choose the attenuation ratio to in order to see the correct voltage. So for example in older Keysight 3000 series scopes, you can only select a ratio out of some fixed values, and one of those values is 20. So that's why I have used 953 ohm resistor. That along with the 50 ohm termination makes 1 to 20 attenuation. But actually in this scope you can just freely choose the ratio. So I could put here, if I used 1k resistor, I could just choose 21 as attenuation ratio, but now it's 20, so that's it.